Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. So today I'm gonna be doing a full set of acrylic nails using colored acrylics. So the first thing that I'm doing is going in and pushing back the cuticles, and this is going to expose the new growth and help with reducing lifting. As always, you can use any type of cuticle pusher, whether it's metal, plastic, or wood, as long as it can be disinfected. After that, I'm going in with a 180 sanding band to remove the shine from the natural nail, and I am using the Scarlett Melody Susie nail drill, which I really recommend. I've been using this one since June of 2019. I use it every day and I haven't had any problems at all whatsoever. So I'll be sure to leave their information down below so you guys can go check them out. But remember that when you're removing the shine from the natural nail, we're literally just removing the shine. We're not filing to thin the nails down, we're not filing to do whatever. We're literally just removing the shine. So if you look at your nails right now and you don't have any acrylic, your nails are going to be shiny. That's because our body produces a lot of oils, and if we leave those oils on the nail and just apply the acrylic, the nails are going to lift. As soon as you wash your hands, they're going to start lifting because that water is going to get trapped underneath the nails. So you have to make sure that you remove the shine really well, so the acrylic will adhere to the nail a lot better. Next, we're going to go in and just dust the nails off, and then we're going to start applying the nail tips. So for the nail tips, I'm going to be using my clear nail tips, and I'm going to be applying them with the KDS glue. Now, whenever you're applying nail tips, the most important thing is making sure that you're applying the correct size tips, because if not, that will cause breakage or lifting. So you want the nail tips to fit exactly from sidewall to sidewall. You don't want the nail tips to be hanging off the nail, because like I said, they will lift or break. And then also, you know, they're just not cute with the nails being so wide. So making sure that, again, we apply the right size tips. And sometimes, you know, a lot of the time for me, like some of the tips, you know, one might be too big for their nail and then the next one below would be too small. So what I do is I just go with the bigger nail tips, just file it down on the sides just a little bit, just enough to where it will fit perfectly on the natural nail from sidewall to sidewall. But other than that, you just apply the nail glue on the nail tip, place it down, hold it for a few seconds, and that's it. And we're going to do that on both hands. After that, we're going to go in and just trim the nails, which she's going to keep them this length. So what we're going to do is just trim the side of the nails because she wants them coffin. So that way, that will save us a little bit of time whenever we start shaping the nails. Not too much, but you know, it still save us some time, and that's better than nothing. Alrighty, so I'm gonna go in with my straight edge nail clipper. I know you guys heard that, a straight edge nail clipper. You don't wanna go in there with one that's curved like the regular ones, because you're gonna mess up your shape. You're gonna cut too much off, and then it's gonna give you more of a stiletto shape instead of coffin. So after I'm finished doing this, I'm gonna go in with my 8080 hand file, and we're gonna shape up the nails. And since we already basically cut them into a coffin shape, you know, this is just going to save us a little bit of time when it comes to the shaping. And yes, she did want her thumbnails cut down. She always likes them a little bit shorter so she can text. But like I said, we're going in with the 8080 hand file. We're filing both sides and the free edge at exactly a 90 degree angle, and then just blending the nail tip right in the middle. That way, you know, whenever we apply the acrylic, it's not gonna show a smile line. But since we're doing colored acrylic, it really does not matter about that part, but it's just a habit for me, which is why I do it. But again, y'all, make sure that whenever you're shaping, you're holding your file at exactly a 90 degree angle. Your angle will make or break your shape, because if you lean it even, you know, slightly inwards, or, you know, however, you're going to round your corners off and you're not going to have that perfect coffin shape. So remember, a 90 degree angle. Alright, so after we finish shaping up the nails, I just dust the nails off, and then I'm going in with the JC Beauty Concepts Primer, and I just apply that on the natural nail, and I always only do the primer, and that, you know, works for me. So, you know, if you feel more comfortable using the dehydrator as well, that's completely fine. Next, I'm gonna go in with the clear acrylic by JC Beauty Concepts, which I absolutely love. It's so easy to work with, so I definitely recommend it 100%. So we're gonna do that on all of the nails, just a small bead, and this is just so next time whenever she comes back for a fill in 2 or 3 weeks, you know, and if she wants a different colored acrylic, which most likely she will, we can just file away the colored acrylic, and then she'll still have the clear underneath. That way, you know, she's not stuck with that same color for, you know, however long. So also, this just helps with, you know, not having to have your clients soak their nails off every time. You can just file away the colored acrylic and, you know, just replace it with a different color. But again, the products that I'm using are by JC Beauty Concepts, as well as the two blue ones that I'm going to be using. Alrighty, so after we finish doing the clear over all of the nails, we're gonna do an ombre for the pinky and the ring finger. So I'm doing the lighter blue on the tip and then the teal color at the back. And remember that when you're doing an ombre, you wanna make sure that whenever you apply the color that's going closer to the cuticle area, that you brush it down super, super gently, because you don't wanna brush it all the way down towards the tip. You just want it to blend right in the middle with the color that's on the tip. And then after that, once you have a nice blend, we're gonna go in and just encapsulate with the clear, because remember that the colored acrylic, that's just for color, but to actually build your strength, you do that with the clear acrylic. So again, we're gonna do that on this pinky and the ring finger, and then the rest of the nails are gonna be the lighter blue, which is the one on the tip. Thank you. Alrighty, so as I mentioned earlier, we're doing the two fingers, the pinky and the ring finger, with the ombre. And initially, we're gonna do the ombre on all of the nails, so that's why you're gonna see me go in and do the lighter blue on all of the tips, because I was gonna go in and do the teal color at the back and do the ombre. But then she ended up changing her mind and decided that she just wanted the lighter pink, or sorry, not the lighter pink, but the lighter blue on the rest of the nails. So that's why, you know, you'll see me changing it up. Okay, so after we finish with the ring finger, now we're gonna go in and just do the lighter blue on all of the nails. Since we've already done the tip, now we're just applying the acrylic closer to the cuticle area and just applying enough to where you have a nice coverage and the color doesn't look patchy or anything, like the color is all even. And then we go in and encapsulate with the clear. And remember, to when you encapsulate, you know, you're building your strength, you're building your apex, you're building your thickness at the tip with the clear. The color is just for color. Alrighty, so I went in and did the clear on all of the nails on this hand, and then we're gonna do the exact same thing we did on the other hand, except for the two ombre nails are gonna be the index finger and the middle finger, but everything else is gonna be the same as far as the application. And also another thing that I wanted to mention is make sure that as you're working, you want to make sure that you're constantly wiping off your brush on a paper towel, because if not, the colored acrylic is going to get stuck in your brush, and then it's going to be really hard to have a smooth application because the acrylic is going to keep getting stuck in your brush. Alrighty, so I forgot to show you guys what colors I was using, but the lighter one was the number 7, and then the teal one was number 11. And like I said, these were both by JC Beauty Concepts as well as the clear. So now I'm just going to go in and reshape the nails. And this is just, you know, to get, to redefine the shape basically, because once you apply the acrylic, it does take away from your shape and it kind of round your corners off. So just go in and redefine that shape, but same thing, following the sides and the free edge at exactly a 90 degree angle. So after we finish reshaping the nails, I'm just going in with my fine drill bit, and we're just going to file all of the nails, but going around the cuticle area first, going from the right side all the way over to the left side, going back and forth until you're able to see where the cuticle is, where the natural nail is, and where the acrylic is. That way we know that the acrylic is not on the skin and you won't get any lifting. And also, if you're a beginner, I definitely recommend that you use the ceramic drill bits, which is the white ones. Because I just feel like the carbide ones are more sharper, I guess I could say. So these would definitely work a lot better. You know, as far as like, because I know some people are like, you know, scared to cut their clients, but the only way to get better is by practicing. So even if you need to use it at a really low speed, that is completely fine. Just work with it until you feel comfortable. But I know for me, when I first started doing nails, I was getting a lot of lifting, and it was because I was so scared to cut someone that I would like act like I was going around the cuticle area, but I would just go around it like maybe 2 or 3 times and then that was it, but I wasn't really focusing on that area. But that's really what was causing lifting for me. Like I always say, lifting can come from a number of things, whether it's not prepping the nail correctly, applying the tips that are not the correct size, from not having the correct liquid to powder ratio, and most importantly, from not sealing the acrylic around the cuticle area. This definitely has to be like the most important step, so make sure that you focus, you know, more time on the cuticle area, and then of course making sure that the rest of the nail is nice and smooth, but making sure that you seal the acrylic around the cuticle area. And I cannot stress that enough. Alrighty, so after we finish filing the nail, filing the nails, I'm gonna go in and just buff all of the nails. And this is going to get rid of any of the scratches left on the nails from the hand file or the e-file. So make sure that you buff really, really good. And then if you notice, I run my thumb over the top of the nail to feel on it and see if it's nice and smooth. If it still feels a little bit rough, then I go in and buff a little bit more. Alrighty, so after that, I just dust the nails off and then I'm wiping them off with an alcohol wipe. And then after that, we're gonna go in with a white gel polish. This one is gonna be Perfect White by Madame Glam, which you guys know are my favorite gel polishes. And we're just gonna do like basically outlining a smile line, if that makes sense. So just basically outlining like a French tip, but we're not filling in the tip, we're just doing the outline. So we're gonna do that on all of the nails. But y'all, I really, really like those two colors together. They look so good. But again, this is Madame Glam Perfect White, and we're just gonna do this on all of the nails. Afterwards, we're gonna cure each hand for 30 seconds, and then we're gonna do a top coat and cure for 60 seconds. Alrighty, so we finished doing the outline on all of the nails, and then now I'm gonna go in with the Madame Glam No Wipe Top Coat, and I'm gonna apply that on all of the nails and curing for 60 seconds. Alrighty y'all, so here is the final look. They turned out really, really pretty. I love the colors and I just hope you guys enjoyed. So as always, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Follow me on Instagram at GetNail32 and I will see you guys next time.